Hello and welcome to my channel, Hardware AI. In this video, we are going to have a look at the new Raspberry Pi high quality camera, compare it to the old version 2 camera, and train the image segmentation model to divide humans from a background in video stream on your Raspberry Pi. When I heard that we are getting a sample of new high quality camera, I was immediately interested to try it out for shooting videos. The old camera module, despite having 8 megapixels, had poor optics and smallish sensor size, so it was hardly suitable for YouTube videos and photography. The specs for HQ sensor look good. By the way, what are these specs? We'll just ignore the old module version 1 here for brevity and compare the specs for version 2 and high quality modules. The new high quality module can take still pictures with resolution up to 4056 by 3040 pixels and videos up to 1980 by 1080 pixels. I'm not a photography expert by any means, but Eli and I know that megapixels are not everything when it comes to photo and video quality, contrary to what smartphone commercials want you to believe. The sensor size and good optics matter a lot. New high-quality camera module has approximately 50% greater area per pixel for improved low-light performance than the existing camera module version 2, and it's designed to work with interchangeable lenses in both C and CS mount form factors. Last week, when I got the sample, I only had a 25mm 10MP telephoto lens and was quite surprised when I first connected to Raspberry Pi 4 and took some really good pictures of my forehead. It is a telephoto lens, so it is really good for taking pictures of objects far away. So I played with it a little bit, took some nice close-up pictures of objects I had in my apartment, but I wasn't able to meaningfully compare it to the old version 2 module because of the optics. Here are some pictures I took at that time. This week I got another lens, 8-50mm 3MP lens, and I was able to make more comparison shots. The shots were taken using new high quality camera module, version 2 camera module, and Canon D700 with 18-135 focal length lens. And here's the example of video recording with a 25mm 10MP telephoto lens, the original lens I got. Overall, the image quality feels much closer to DSLR cameras. You can get these nice clear shots with blurred background and crisp foreground. Let's try using new high-quality camera module with image segmentation model for some neural network image magic. We will use Accelerate to train our image segmentation model that will segment images into two classes, background and humans. We then will convert Keras model to TF-Lite model for faster inference on Raspberry Pi and use the inference result to blur or remove background from the video feed. Semantic segmentation models, aka image segmentation, classify each pixel of input image into a category as opposed to image classification models, which classify the whole picture into a category. And object detection models, which output bounding boxes for objects present in the image. In Accelerate, SegNet Basic architecture is used for image segmentation. Here is a picture of a view of this architecture. The input of feature extractor, in our case it's MobileNet Alpha 0.5, is being fed into decoder, which consists of convolutional 2D and upsampling layers. Upsampling layers are direct opposite of pooling layers. They increase the feature map size instead of decreasing it. The final decoder output feature maps are fed into a softmax classifier for pixel-wise classification. Open the Colab notebook I prepared and follow the steps there to train and convert your model. In the latest version of Accelerate, I added several converter options for TF-Lite models. They correspond to options in post-training quantization documentation for TensorFlow Lite. TF-Lite Dynamic is dynamic range quantization, and TF-Lite Full Int is full integer quantization with float fallback. The model will still have the float inputs and outputs. Once the training is done, copy the TF-Lite model to your Raspberry Pi and execute the following commands. In order to achieve the best inference speed, you need to install latest version of TensorFlow Lite Interpreter 2.3.0 with threading enabled. You can download binaries from the GitHub repository or compile them yourself. Then download the example scripts and run them. If you use the latest official TensorFlow interpreter package, which is 2.1.0, you need to change the line here because the latest official TensorFlow interpreter package does not support threading yet. The label file is just a TXT file with names of classes in the following format: background, human. After the script is running, open your web browser and enter IP address of your Raspberry Pi with on the port 5000 to see the live stream from the camera. The inference speed of optimized model with number of threads 4 option enabled is about 150 milliseconds per frame. The image processing also adds some overhead to it. Remember to use good power supply. When I used a cheap power supply rated for 2.1 amperes, I got under voltage warning and inference speed was close to 300 milliseconds per frame. Hope you liked today's video and it was useful for you. Add me on LinkedIn if you have any questions and subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notified about more interesting projects involving machine learning and robotics. Until the next time!